This week, the legendary Larry Gogan announced his departure from 2FM. This will no doubt leave a huge hole in broadcasting and in the hearts of everyone in Irish radio. Over the next few minutes, we're going to go into the history and life of this legendary broadcaster, as well as a few of his classic moments.
Larry!
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 Lorcan Larry Gogan was born in 1938 in Dublin and was the son of a newspaper owner. Gogan started in radio in the 1960s after finishing school. He broadcast his first programme on RTE Radio 1. He soon became a well-known presenter and was one of a handful of DJs playing almost exclusively pop music. When 2FM launched in 1979, under the then name RTE Radio 2, Gogan was in the starting lineup of DJs. Gogan has also presented a variety of programmes over the years, including Picking the Pops and Go To Show, but is definitely most well-known for The Golden Hour. On The Golden Hour, Larry plays old favourites and classic songs from yesteryear. Gogan stayed at 2FM right up until his announced departure at the end of this month, meaning he will have been a fixture on 2FM for four decades. Having previously commentated for television, Gogan was the Irish radio commentator for the Eurovision Song Contest. He provided commentary between 1984 and 2001, and again in 2008. Although he was dropped from the commentary team for 2009, he continued to be part of the Irish delegation up until the 2011 contest. Gogan is famous for his Just a Minute quiz, a quiz where callers have to answer a variety of trivia questions in just a minute. When contestants only get a couple of questions correct, he's famous for the catchphrase, "Oh, they didn't really suit you." The quiz has produced its fair share of bloopers which have gone down in Irish folklore. Here are a few famous examples.
The Taj Mahal, you know, up to the dental hospital.
which is a football field.
Which it is. Yes.
On a technicality, they're right. Yes.
Where's the Great Wall? You know, yeah. China. It's the right answer, but the, yeah. Where's the Great Wall? Kremlin, which is a Chinese restaurant there, seemingly, called the Great Wall.
Yes.
And only last week has somebody complete this duo, Curly Wee and Dudley Moore. Uptown is associated with Shakespeare, Hamlet, and they all like the black hole of Dakota. I don't know where they get it. It's the song. It's the association.
Of course,
kind of,
people get justified.
Do. And recently there was one about who uses grease paint, and the fellow says a jockey, and I immediately was going to say no, it's an actor. And one of the sound fellows who know those things, says, but there's a horse called grease paint, you know. So he was quite right.
Gogan met his wife Florrie when she was just 15. They were engaged 2 years later and married when she was 21. They had five children. Florrie unfortunately developed breast cancer and died in January 2002 while Gogan was recovering from heart surgery. He says, "When something happens at work, I say to myself, I must tell Florrie that. And then I remember she's not there anymore." On his official website, Gogan lists Katie Lied by Stevie Dan as his favourite album of all time, while the song that drives him mad is Save Your Love by Renee and Renato. His favourite film is Casablanca. Further details have since emerged that Larry's departure is due to his failing health and the time-consuming nature of his treatments. As well as suffering from arthritis, Larry gets dialysis 3 times a week. Dialysis is a procedure commonly associated with diabetics or people with kidney failure, whereby the blood in a person's body is pumped out, cleaned, and then pumped back in. Aside from being extremely unpleasant, it is also incredibly time-consuming. As Larry has said, each session takes 3 hours or more. We wish Larry the best of wishes and the best of health in the future. Fortunately, Larry won't be leaving our lives or our radios, as he will be moving to RTE Gold, where he will continue to provide classic entertainment to the nation. From everyone here at the Kerry ETB Radio Course, we wish him the very best of luck and health in his new life.
That's all, folks.